Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. So in the last previous lecture, we have studied what is rate of reaction and what is the types of rate of reaction. And now we are concerning with what is instantaneous rate of reaction. And based on that, by the graphical representation, we could understand what is instantaneous rate of reaction much more deeply. And we could determine that at what time, what would be the concentration, or the concentration has been decreased or increased at what level at that particular time. So friends, as you can see on your screen, there are two graphs. One is for the reactant and one is for the product. And you know that as the time spends or as the time moves forward, the concentration of reactant goes on decreasing. So this is the concentration of reactant, and according to time, the concentration goes on decreasing as the time goes on increasing. When I talk about the product one, we'll do it simultaneously so that we could get a very good idea. For product, as you know, as the time increases, the concentration of the product will go on increasing. So since it is an instantaneous rate of reaction we are talking about, so at a particular time, what would be the concentration? That could be determined by this graph. How? Suppose I have took a tangent of this thing, where I have to determine that at this time, what would be the concentration of the reactant. So I will take the time in consideration, and according to that I could determine what is the concentration. But how could I determine the rate of reaction? This is a very simple thing. How? Because this tangent that I have drawn right now for a particular time to determine the concentration at that particular time.
So by this time we could determine what is the concentration of the reactant at that particular time. So by this thing, we also know that as the time increases, the concentration goes on decreasing. So by the help of this time and by the help of this concentration, we could determine the instantaneous rate of reaction for the reactant. How? See, we have made a tangent. So this tangent is moving from higher to lower, means it is a negative tangent. So we could determine the slope of this tangent, and by determining the slope of tangent, we could easily find out the rate of reaction. So the rate of this reaction when the reactant is being decreasing is will be the nothing but it will be the slope. It will be the negative slope that we have determined by this tangent. While in case of the product side, as the concentration will increase if the time goes on increasing, so even there we could determine the concentration of the product at that particular that instant of time. We could determine the concentration of product. So by the help of this tangent, we could determine the slope, and that slope will be the rate of the product. That would be the rate of the reaction. That would determining the slope, we could determine the instantaneous rate of reaction for the product. And hence you can see the slope is a positive, so therefore the slope will be a positive for the product, while the slope is negative for the reactant. So by the help of this two, we could determine whether the reaction is going at what speed, at what instant we could get that concentration, and we could determine the rate of reaction also. I hope you have understand this lecture. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you have got to clear what is instantaneous rate of reaction by following this graph. And please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.